Good afternoon, friends. One morning, the father was surprised to see his little son waiting outside the door as his father was rushing to get into the car to go to his office. So the father asked the child, "What is it, my son, you want?" And the boy asked him, "Father, let me know how much money you make per hour." "Why?" "No, I just want to know." Then he said, "Maybe $50. "Thank you, Dad." And the boy went home, went inside the house, and asked the mother, "My mom, can you borrow me $25? And the mother asked, "Why do you need?" "No, I have $25. I want 25 more." The mother gave him the money. The evening father returned home, and the boy gave the $50 to him and said, "Daddy, can you spend 1 hour with me? I know you are rushing every day to the office to make money, but you have no time for me." My dear friends, in today's first reading, we heard Moses telling the people that the Lord would be making a great prophet like him the years to come to lead the people. Because the God who saw the misery, the sufferings of his children Israel in Egypt, he chose to redeem them by being with them. He would have chosen so many ways, but he decided to redeem the human people from their misery, being one with them. And so he sent prophets after prophets. When the fullness of time came, even the Word of God, Son of God, became man in Jesus Christ. And he lived with us as one among us. And when he started his ministry, as we heard in today's gospel, he taught with authority. And everybody was wondering, what authority does he have? Because Jesus said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord has sent me to set the prisoners free, to proclaim the gospel to the poor." And this Jesus went about choosing disciples, as we heard in the last 2 weeks. He chose men, as Mark says, to be with him. To be with him and to be sent out. The important thing is, he chose disciples to be with him and to be sent out. And in the Acts of the Apostles, Peter bears witness, "We are witnesses to all that Jesus did, what he preached." And that's why St. John also writes in his first letter, "We bear witness to all that Jesus did, because we were with him, we witnessed what he did, we touched him." And that is what gave them the authority. As Peter went to the temple, He was able to tell the lame man, I do not have silver and gold, but I have Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, get up and walk. He was able to extend his hand and make the lame man walk. My dear friends, we are all baptized. We are all given the Spirit of the Lord. We form families. But do our children really experience that we parents and elders have time for them? Jesus chose the disciples to be with him and to be sent out. He was with his parents 30 long years, living the regular family life, every year going with the parents to Jerusalem temple to hear the word of God, to experience God the Father. Do our children come with us to the house of God, who brings us together, who gives meaning to our life, who binds us with his love? My dear friends, unless we are bound together by the love of God in our families, and unless our children experience that the family is built upon God's love, God's presence, God's guidance, our families will not be a happy home. Our families will not be a place where we share each other. Only electronic devices will dominate. We may have money to buy the most modern equipment, but that will not fill the heart. As St. Augustine said, unless we rest in God, our hearts will not find peace, rest. We will go after one after the other modern equipments only. And we will not have the courage and energy to drive out the social evils and to stand for witnesses to the truth, real gospel value. My dear friends, once again, just like Jesus did, 30 long years being with his parents, enjoying the parental love, experiencing how this family had always connection with the temple in Jerusalem, and filled with his spirit. Let us try to take the Spirit of the Lord with us to our home. Let our children be guided by our love, by the Spirit of Jesus Christ. At least once in a way, let us try to open the Word of God and read it and tell them, this is what is our light, our way and truth. God bless you.